The premium behavior is pretty erratic, and we are down by close to 2 points, two and a half points. We are down by close to 2.5 points, and Bank Nifty is looking very strong. Looks like it's going to give a breakout towards the upside today. So we have a 15850 straddle combined with a 15750 and 950 strangle. Alright, the time is just 10:20 and already we had a good roller coaster ride. So we gapped down, we tried to move lower, and then again we got bought into, and then we looked like we're gonna give an upside breakout, and then that breakout has been negated, and now we are trading at the day's low, looking like we're gonna break down. So Nifty IT has been used to manipulate the markets as of now. So around 1/3 of my positions are at 15700, 15900 strangle, and another 2/3 are at 15950 and 650 strangle. So it's a 200 point and a 300 point strangle. So at one point I was down by somewhere around 13-14k, and at another point I was up by around 6-7k. So this is the kind of erratic premium behavior that we have been seeing. So it's a proper V. It's a proper V-shaped kind of a move. So looks like this kind of V-shaped kind of moves is happening quite often, close to 11:22, and we are still down by around 3 points. Around 3 points. But that also includes a 3.4k loss in the Bank Nifty put option. So when Bank Nifty was taking a support near the CPR levels, I shorted the Bank Nifty put options with a stop loss just below the day's low. And that stop loss got triggered and I had to take a loss in that. And in the Bank Nifty account, I have booked a loss of 3.5k, not gonna trade today. And even in the Nifty account, I'm not targeting much, most probably another 4 or 5 points. Just I'll get this account up in green and probably I'd be exiting it out. That is because even a small tick, both on the upside and on the downside, is kind of disrupting my entire mark to market. So you can't expect to sit through a wide MTM swings, because that affects your psychology, correct? The moment this support starts getting breached, most probably I'll exit, because iske niche baithne ka koi sense nahi banta hai. So 15750 levels, most probably I'll hold on to 15750 levels and try to make some adjustments to the position. So adjustment kya rahega? It's just that we have a 15850 and 900 call. So this 15850 call is only to manage the spiking puts. Agar niche ki taraf puts zyada spike hona shuru ho jata hai, then this 15850 call will give me a cushion up till some extent. Matlab agar market days low ke aas pas bhi aa jata hai, of course I'll be looking at a loss, but this loss wouldn't be that big. Alright, so yeah. So jab tak days low breach nahi hota hai, I'm not sure I'm going to make any adjustments. And at the same time, jab tak ye S1 jo level hai, this level, 15815 levels, jab tak 15815 levels breach nahi hota hai, most probably I won't push this 15850 calls to 15900. Once we start approaching this level, so 15815 levels ke aaspas, is level ke aaspas aane ke liye, we have to breach the sloping 20 moving average. So which gives us a confirmation that yes, we are heading higher, and in that case I'll be shifting all these 15850 calls to 15900 and I'll be sitting on a 200 point strangle. So currently we have a part 200 and a part 150 point strangle. Alright guys, the time is close to 1:10 and I've decided to come out of my position somewhere around 12:06. So when market looked like it's gonna break towards the upside, I took an exit. But look at these spikes. So 1-2 spike. So if you look at the futures chart, you can see that even a small volume is causing a huge amount of spikes on both the sides, which is kind of, you know, I'm not sure like if SEBI is even looking at this, because this is the sure shot way of getting the retail traders killed. All right so retail traders are the ones who have small to medium sized capital, and they are the ones who work with stop losses and stuff like that. And especially on an intraday basis, of course, like you have a lot of stop losses in the system, and candles like these, this candle and this candle, they are the ones to take out all the stop losses of retail traders. And it has become very easy compared to, you know, the pre margin rule era, for the retail, I mean for the institutional traders to actually take the stop losses. The volatility that has been implied by the option prices through IV and the volatility that we are seeing in the market is nowhere close. Definitely not a conducive situation for the option sellers. I took a loss of minus 4.4k, which is slightly less than 1.5 points. So since the quantity I was trading with was 3600, I decided to book at 4.4k minus, and in that 4.4k minus, and in that around 3.4k came from the directional trade that I took on Bank Nifty. So when it comes to the Nifty strangle, I pretty much didn't take any loss, pretty much exited cost to cost, but overall in this account I've taken minus 4.4k loss, and here also I've taken a minus 3.5k loss. And I won't be taking any trades considering that there will be Fed meeting announcement tonight Indian standard time. So we'll see how the markets open tomorrow. I'll trade the expiry, and after I'm done trading the expiry, most probably I'll be taking some July positional trade. And that's the end of my trading day, guys. Booking a 8k loss, and I'll see you guys tomorrow.